Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we have a topic which is direct versus indirect cash flow methods. So there are two kind of methods that are used in the cash flow statement in case of calculating the cash flow from operations. So when we see that, we have direct versus indirect costs that are direct versus indirect cash flow methods that have been involved. Let's try and understand this method in a detailed format. Now, if you see the direct versus the indirect cost methods, in the direct cost, the adjustments are made to the in the indirect method, there is adjustments that are made to the net income, and there are no adjustments that are made to direct to the net income in the direct method. Okay, let me go through what we call as inception level. Now, companies prepare the income statement using both the expenses and the revenues. Direct versus indirect cash flow methods wants to look at their overall performance over the period of time. Likewise, the CFS, the cash flow statement, is another financial fin statement that every investor should look at. So the cash flow statement contains a three sets of activities. Muchly said, it's operating, it's investing, and third is financing. So usually the investing and the financing sections are calculated in a very similar manner. But when it comes to calculating the CFS, the cash flow from the operations, two methods of calculations are majorly used. One is the indirect method, and another one is the direct method. First, the indirect method. The indirect method of the cash flow uses the what we call as the net income as the base, and it does not the adjustments that are needed, that is, you know, adding and subtracting the variables to convert the total net income to the cash flow from the operations. The direct method of the cash flow in operation activity includes the cash that is being received from the customers and the cash that has been paid to the suppliers and the employees and others. So the cash can also be paid for the income tax, interest, and various other variables. The direct method of cash flow, it starts with what we call as cash transactions, such as cash received and cash paid, while ignoring the non-cash transactions. And if you see the indirect cash flow method, on the other hand, the calculation starts from net income, and then we go along adjusting the rest. Let's understand this with the help of the infographics to get more insight. The cash flow from the indirect method and the cash flow from the direct method. The indirect method uses the net income as the base, and then it adds up all the non-cash expenditures like depreciations, amortization, and then deduct all the non-cash incomes like profit on sale of scraps, and then the changes in the assets and liabilities, that is the current assets and the current liabilities, to produce the overall cash flow statement. So all those changes will be adjusted here to get the final amount. And the direct method only uses the cash transaction, that is the cash spent and the cash received, to produce the cash flow statement. Now, the net income, it automatically gets converted into cash flow after making all the adjustments, adding back and then making the final adjustments into that to get the final amount. But the cash flow from the direct method, the reconciliation is done to separate the cash flow from the others. It is used to reconciliation is done to separate the cash flow from the others. Now, what are the factors that are taken? All the factors are taken into consideration when we talk about the indirect method. Every other factors, and only non-cash transactions like depreciation are ignored. Rest, all the cash transactions are covered here. How the preparation is done? See, preparations are mainly needed during the conversion of the net income into the cash flow statement. When you convert the net income into the cash flow statement, that's when the whole agenda or the efforts is gonna lie. And there is no such preparation as required, because it's a straightforward process. The accuracy. The cash flow statement under the indirect method is not very accurate, because you see the adjustments, and the adjustments, they may or may not create some differences, which is subjective in nature. While under direct method is very accurate, that there is no need for any adjustments. It's a straightforward game. It's a bullet shot determination of the cash. What is the time taken? It takes less amount of time compared to the direct method. It takes more amount of the time, because you know you have to record down each and every item over here. Over here, it's just the adjustments that you need to do. Now, what is the popularity? This method is predominantly used by many companies, and it is used compared to the indirect. They are only used by very few companies that use this method. the more importance is placed on indirect method because of the way it has been disclosed, the way the things have been added back, so that, you know, all those expenses do not come into picture, and the adjustments, they show the right picture of the cash flow from the operation, but that doesn't go well with the direct method. Now we'll try and understand some of the key differences between a direct and indirect method of cash flow. Direct cash flow method and IDC. The first one of the key differences between the direct cash flow versus indirect cash flow method is the type of the transaction used to produce the cash flow state, and the indirect method uses the what we call as the net income as the base and convert the income into the cash flow through the use of adjustments. So direct method only takes into account the cash transactions into account and produces the cash flow from the operations. The cash flow of the indirect method basically makes sure to convert the net income in terms of the cash flow automatically. Cash flow from the direct method, on the other hand, you know, records the cash transactions separately, and they produce, says the CFS. The cash flow from the indirect method needs the preparation as the adjustments that have been made to require, and it requires really great amount of time, and the preparation time for the cash flow for the direct method isn't much, since, you know, it only uses the cash transactions. The accuracy of the cash flow from the indirect method is little less, as it uses the adjustments. Comparatively, the cash flow from the direct method is more accurate, as the adjustments are not used here. So what's the difference between the direct and the indirect cash flow method? Let's have a look. The difference that we are supposed to look, we have already done. We have tried to incorporate every single differences. So let me give a final conclusion on this. Both the direct and the direct and indirect cash flow method is useful in different points, and they can be used depending on the situation and the requirement. The indirect method, you can say that the indirect method is most popular among companies, but it takes a lot of time to prepare before recording, and it's not very accurate, as many adjustments are. If you see, for the direct method, on the other hand, it does not need any prep time other than segregating the cash transactions from the non-cash transactions, as it is, you know, more accurate than the indirect method. That's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.